Good morning, everyone. This is Vishwanathan, Assistant Professor from Electrical and Electronics Engineering from St. Mary's Engineering College. So today I am going to discuss about the relation between line voltage, line current, and phase current. If I am taking the three-phase supply, that is R, Y, B, these are the phases, and another one is the neutral if I am taking. The voltage in between any phase 2, the voltage between any phase 2 to the point, I can write it as phase voltage, and the voltage in between any two phases, that will be indicated by line voltage. Means the voltage in between any phase 2 neutral. Means if I am taking R phase and neutral, that will be phase voltage. And if I am taking voltage between any two phases, that will be line voltage. See, the relation between VL and V phase means line voltage and phase voltage, and line current and phase current. So see how it is. If I am taking a star connected network, for this, if I am connecting the three phase supply, this R phase, then what will happen? Here the junction point, which we call it as neutral point, that is and indicating by N, in between R phase and neutral. R phase and neutral means one phase and one neutral. We know that this will be indicated by V phase. Means in between one phase and neutral, we will call it as phase voltage. And we are coming into the voltage in between any two phases, that is R phase and Y phase. This R phase, this is by phase. In between any two phases, that will be line voltage. Now, while coming into the currents, if I am coming into the currents, then what will happen for the star connected network? If I am removing, if I am disconnecting the B phase for our current phase, then wherever we are giving a supply, the current which will flow through this R phase winding, and it will come reach to neutral, and again it will come to flow through Y phase winding. Means the current which is flowing through R2Y, then same current will flow through this particular series connected two windings. Series connected two windings. So that's why in this case I can write line current is equal to phase current. In this case I can write line current is equal to phase current. And whatever the voltage is in between, the voltage because R phase and neutral is V phase. And the voltage across R phase and Y phase means any two phases, that will be indicated by VL. So now let us see the phase voltages. Let us see the phase voltages, which is equal to in between R phase and neutral, this phase voltage, and in between Y phase and neutral, this is the phase voltage, and in between V phase and neutral, this is the phase voltage. So that's why I am indicating lines. Now, while coming into the line voltage is nothing but in between any two phases. I can write V, R, Y, which is equal to V, Y, B, which is equal to V, B, R for the balanced condition. Now, the relation between phase line current and phase current both are same in the star connected. But while coming into the voltage, the line voltage and phase voltage not equal. Those what? Not equal. So that's why, what is the relation between phase voltage and line voltage? We have to see by using the vector diagram. Now if I am drawing a vector diagram for this, I am taking here R phase, I am taking here R phase voltage, and 120 degrees apart, apart, if I am taking here V, Y, and that is in between the voltage between Y phase and neutral. And again 120 degrees apart, here also 120 degrees apart I am taking, that is V, V, and if I am taking V, V, and the voltage in between V phase and neutral, that is V, V, and I am taking. Now, let us see the relation in between current will flow in opposite direction. So I can write here the phase voltage of the line voltage VR is equal to VRY, which is equal to VRM plus VYN. But we have to observe here the current of current which is flowing through R phase, which is going in this direction, that is going from R to neutral. And here in this case, in the Y phase, the current is going from Y to M. Means these power in opposite directions. So that's why I can write here, I can, means R phase current is opposite this Y phase current. So that's why I can indicate this by minus. So it is not plus. So now, while coming into this, see in this case, for R, VRL, the sum of these two, means sum of vector sum of R, VRL, and the vector sum of VRL and VYL is equal to VRL. So that's why VRL is there, VRL is in on same phase. But when coming into the VYL, it is opposite to this. Why? Because it is in negative sign. Negative sign is there. So that's why I am indicating this opposite to this, that is minus VYN. Minus VYN. And if I am extending this, the parallel lines I am drawing, in parallel to this and parallel to this, if I draw it like this, here one tension point will come. That point from origin to this point, if I am drawing a line, this will be the sum of vector sum of these two phases, that is VRL and minus VYM. So that will be equal to this. So that's why VRY I can write. And we know that from VRL to VBM, 120 degrees is there, and from here to here, this will be 60 degrees because half of that, and from here to here it will be 30 degrees only. 30 degrees only. I am indicating this as 4. And see here, this will be, if I am drawing a parallel line like this, then if I am indicating this as M, this will be 90 degrees. That is perpendicular to that. So if I am indicating this point is M. Now if I write a cos equation, that is cos 30 degrees here. So I can write here OM. From here to here, this is the base. By hypotenuse is VRM. VRM. And cos 30 degrees we know, that is root 3 by 2, which is equal to OM. What is OM? This is from here to here, O to M. This will be half of this total length of vector, that VRY. So I can write here VRY. Why? Because it's half of that one. And here I can write VR. Now these two and these two both will be gets cancelled. Now I can write V root 3 into V R, and if it is coming left side, then it will be equal to V R Y. Here we know VRL is the phase voltage and VRY is the line voltage. Now I can write here root 3 V phase is equal to VL. Root 3 V phase is equal to VL. It means the line voltage, which is equal to root 3 times of phase voltage in case of star connected network. Whatever the currents, the line current and phase currents both are same in the star connected network. And while coming into the delta connection, while coming into the delta connection, how it will be, let us see. If I am drawing a delta connected network, I am giving a three phase supply to this, R phase, Y phase, and D phase. D phase, three phases I am connecting here. Then let us see the current which is flowing from R phase. I am indicating this as I1, and the current which is giving by or supplying by Y phase, I am indicating this is I2, and the current which is supplying by D phase, I am indicating this as I3. Means that here the line currents are I1, I2 and I3. These three are the line currents. And what are the phase currents? If I am taking this as the R phase, means R dash, if I am taking. And this is Y and Y dash I am taking. And B dash I am taking. It means this is the R phase winding. It means the current which is flowing through this R phase winding, I am indicating by IR, that is line current in R phase. And this will be IY, the current which is going through Y phase, that is IY, and the by IM. And by coming into this, if I draw writing a current equation, the case if I am applying KCL equation, this will become a row. At this junction, then what will happen? The current entering into the junction is must be equal to the current leaving from the junction. So current distance are entering, I1 entering and IB entering. So I can find I1 plus IB, which is equal to the current which is leaving from this, that will be IR. I can rewrite this equation, I1 is equal to IR minus IB. IR minus IB. Let us see here, IR and IB we have taken. And while coming into this voltage, the voltage between R phase and B phase, R phase and B phase, this will be time voltage and which must be equal to B phase. Why? Because here there was no pivot point, here between any two phases, that we can call it as line voltage and phase voltage, both are same in this case. The start connection, line current, phase current are same. While coming into the delta connection, line voltage, phase voltage, both are same. Now, let us see, this I1 is the time current and this is IR is the phase current which is flowing through R phase, IB is the phase current that is flowing through B phase. Now, if I want to draw a vector diagram, that is, I am making here IR, the current which is flowing through R phase, I am taking a phase current from you, and here I am taking IB. I am taking here IB, that is phase current, which will be mentioned, which will be phase 120 degrees apart, and again in between this I am taking IY, this is also 120 degrees apart. And by seeing this we are able to observe that the R phase is the vector sum of this IR and IB, which must be equal to I1. See how the vector sum of we have to draw. See R phase is here, I phase is there, I phase current is there. See here, this will be on this vector only, and when coming into the B phase current, we can see here minus negative sign is there. So that's why opposite to I phase current, I have to draw another line, that will be I B with negative sign. And when coming into the vector sum, as previously we have seen, if I am drawing the extension this, it means this line is parallel to this and this line is parallel to this line. Then it will make the junction from origin to here, the junction point. If I am drawing a vector diagram, vector line, then I can indicate this by I1. Why? Because the vector sum of I R phase current and B phase current will be equal to line current, that is I1. Means this I1. Okay. And in between these two phases, what will be the angle? That will be 60 degrees. And while coming into this, the angle between these two will be half of this, that is 30 degrees. And if I am drawing a dotted line in between these, this will become 90 degrees to this line, that is 9 per line, vector 1. So if I am indicating this as M and here it is an origin, then if I am writing a cos equation, then cos 30 degrees is equal to base OM by is the hypotenuse, because of this 30 degrees is this side. How much hypotenuse is how much? That is IR. Now we know that cos 30 degrees is equal to root 3 by 2, which is equal to OM is nothing but it will be half of this line term, I1. It is half of this. So that's why I can write here I1 by 2 by IR. I1 by 2 by IR. And these two and these two both will be cancelled. Now, if I am bringing this left side, I3 root 3 IR, which is equal to I1, which is equal to I1. We know that I am calling this as line current and calling this as phase current. See in this, this is the phase current, this is the line current. So, here phase current is equal to, what are those? IR, which is equal to IY, which is equal to IB for the balance condition. Okay, but VL is equal to I1 is equal to I2 is equal to I3. So I can write here root 3